of you here, what you need is patience, endurance. Those of you who think life is a fanfare, life is war. Life is a battleground. We are in a war ground. This place, life is not a fanfare, it is a warfare. The earlier you understand that, the better it becomes for your life. You are not here to enjoy. Look, if you are looking for enjoyment, there is no ground for you. All the men that made impact on earth don't actually enjoy. No, sir. I want to ask, there is no rich man that sleeps in a swimming pool. Even if your house have a swimming pool, the funny thing is that the number of times you will swim there in a year, maybe 3 or 4 times. Because whatever costs you to afford the swimming pool, if you want to keep moving, then you must not be swimming every day. Now, it's now I'm understanding life. When we were useless those days, my uncle used to work, but everybody was not working. He would go to work, and then before he come, we have cooked 4 times. Cook yam, cook rice, cook this, and he would come and be cursing us. Because he will close work very late, come home, we have eaten 4 times, and we are sitting down watching ball, watching different type of movie. He will enter very tired and angry. He will start insulting before he gets down from his motorbike. Insult everybody in the house. He wasn't having time for the food. Sometimes he serve his food before he get home. It's too cold. We were there before the pot got down. We were watching it, watching to eat the hot food. It's right now we realize that life is not fair. There are people here, you used to say, if you can afford a guinea fowl, a full meat, I will just buy it and buy drink and hide in a room. You know, when you don't have it, you think like you're a foolish boy. There are wishes people here are having. It is, look, the Bible said what? Patient endurance is what you need now. This is what you need. Endurance and patience is what you need. If you want to inherit the promise, to receive the promise that God has given you, this is what you need. Patient endurance. Whatever the Lord has promised you will not come easily. He promised them what? Cana. So, it is the responsibility of God to promise. It is your responsibility to possess that which he has promised. Between the promise and then the land, the possessing, is a process. And that process is not easy. This is where issues of life will come against you, make you frustrated. How can you commit suicide? Which means, at the first place, you were not qualified for the assignment given to you. How are you so tired that you have no option than to die? That's why I believe that no one who commits suicide will make heaven. Why will you die in the first place? Patient endurance. You need to endure. There are people here, you are tired, you are at a very dark place of your life now, so dark that you feel like quitting, you feel like giving up, you feel like just stopping and walking away from whatever you are doing. But this scripture is your scripture. Patient endurance is what you need now. Every champion once upon a time feel like giving up. There's no champion that has never feel like quitting. If you meet any champion, ask him if there was a day in his life he feel like quitting. If that champion tells you that there was no day, then he's a fraud. Because every champion once upon a time wanted to quit. So if you feel like quitting, it is a sign that you're a champion and you're on the Champions League. The only way to win it is to keep fighting. Now, one of the things I want you to understand is that every day is not rosary. Every day, you are expecting every day to be a good day. Every day to be a good day. No, sir. There are days that will be bad. But the Bible said, patient endurance is what you need. Some of you, that is what you are lacking. Your only problem is patient and endurance. You don't know how to endure. You have been given a gospel of what? Fast food. You came in the wilderness. You are performing different and diverse kinds of miracles in the wilderness. Why won't you perform a miracle and send us to the Canaan? Save us all this drama. You will perform a miracle. You are raining manna. If you can rain manna from heaven, the next day we wake up, there is food everywhere. Why won't you sleep and wake up in the land of Canaan? He rained the manna and still kept them there. He gave them water and still kept them there. He divided the Red Sea. If he has the ability to divide the sea into two, what is keeping him from sleeping and waking up in the land of Canaan? Because the Bible says he carried Philip from one place to another place to preach the gospel. God can do it, but he was not doing it because he needed to teach them and he needed to pass a message to you. Whatever happened to them was for our example. You cannot dodge the process. That is why God is intentionally ignoring some people here. He wants you to go through the process. There are men here, when you don't go through the process, you will not be able to mentor people. Some people, you are not just rising as champions, you are rising as mentors. So God will make sure he take you through every single process. There are many people here, what you just need is endurance. That which you carry must go through process. What you are looking for, if really you want to be great, then you should not dodge the process. Those of you who are here, if we make you become a president of Ghana now, you will destroy the nation. You see, there's the president. There are people here, if you just make them president, for 4 years, they will not know the decision to take. They will be confused. You are even saying this year. We can give the assemblyman. They will be confused. So you see, when God intentionally is taking you through process, you should give him the time. Learn what is called endurance. Don't quit. Don't give up. Don't surrender. But there is something greater on the way. Of God, you don't understand. A lot of things are ongoing. Yes, sir. It is a process. It's called the process. Hear me well. There was a day you could not afford a meal. Now you have meals. Don't worry. Things are changing like that. There is a movement. Every day there is a progress. Just make sure that you should not wake up and be lying down. Even if there is nothing to do, read something. Increase in knowledge. Be prepared. Be prepared. You come here in church, presence like this, and you are browsing and laughing. Haven't you realized that there is something following? There is something following you because you want to dodge the process. If you are not doing anything, be praying. If there is no work, sit and be praying. If you are not doing, be praying. Make sure there is a progress every day. Is there a man here who is ready to endure? No matter the hardship, you say, you know what? I'm not giving up now. I am not giving up. I am not quitting.